Hello!
Hello everyone!
Mga kapatid, brothers and sisters, welcome to the online Elim Gathering. Ako po si Barbie Dumlao.
I'm Monica Dumlao, and we're so glad that you could join us. We are hoping and praying that you are all safe and you are all doing well.
Yeah. And of course, as part of the Elim family, we are joined by many others around the world.
That's right.
And those of you who sent your pictures, photos, let's take a look.
To see everyone come together as family, and personally, if I can say, I really like looking at the photos because it really goes to show that the Lord can really dwell in any place, at any time, in anyone, and it's such a nice sight to see.
Mm-hmm. And it's very inspiring.
Very.
And right now, let's just invite the Holy Spirit into our lives as we worship in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
My heart tells me to, I
Dear Lord, we thank you for your presence in our lives, and we continue to hope in you, knowing that you grant us the grace to move forward in hope and in peace and in your strength. And we thank you, Lord, that you give us this opportunity to listen to your word today. And we ask that you may speak in a special way to all of us. In Jesus' name, amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
And to share God's message for us today, please welcome Teacher of the Word, full-time servant of the Lord, presiding elder of Elim Communities, Brother Willy Nakar.
Welcome once again to this online Elim Gathering. Sister Luli and I have been praying for all of you every single day, especially during this extraordinary period in our lives. Bawat isa sa inyo ay pinagdarasal namin na sana ay nasa mabuti kayong kalagayan, lalo-lalo na sa mga hindi pangkaraniwang panahon na ating pinagdaraanan. You know, people say that you always remember where you were during an extraordinary event. I remember we were at an Elim prayer meeting when Cory Aquino lost the election. And this sparked successive events that led to the peaceful EDSA revolution. I remember we were also at the prayer meeting when 9/11 happened. After the prayer meeting, my family and I were having dinner, and we turned on the TV to witness this gruesome terror attack. I remember we were also at home when we witnessed the most awaited canonization of St. John Paul II. Extraordinary events are hard to miss. They not only define our lives, they define history. I would like to talk to you about an extraordinary event that we should all look forward to. The coming of the Lord. Hallelujah. The return of Jesus, ang muling pagbabalik ni Jesus. Not many people talk about this, and because it is not talked about, not many people actually look forward to that one glorious day. Much less, not many people actually prepare for it. Jesus calls it the unknown day and hour. In Matthew 24, verses 36 to 42, we read, "But of that day and hour no one knows, neither the angels of heaven, nor the Son, but the Father alone. For as it was in the days of Noah, so it will be at the coming of the Son of Man. In those days before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, up to the day that Noah entered the ark. They did not know until the flood came and carried them all away. So will it be also at the coming of the Son of Man. Two men will be out in the field, one will be taken and one will be left. Two women will be grinding at the mill, one will be taken and one will be left. Therefore, stay awake, for you do not know on which day your Lord will come." Tayo daw ay dapat magbantay sapagkat hindi natin alam kung anong araw paririto ang ating Panginoon. It is precisely because we do not know when it will happen that we need to prepare for it. Here are five things we can do to prepare for the Lord's return. Number one, watch. In Matthew chapter 13, verse 33, Jesus told them a parable. "The kingdom of heaven is like yeast that a woman took and mixed with 3 measures of wheat flour until the whole batch was leavened." I don't really bake, but what I know is that when you put yeast into the dough, you wait for it to rise. And this takes time. You have to watch it. You wait for the dough to rise. You have to watch and wait. Similarly, we have to be watchers of the coming of the Lord. We have to be joyful in our anticipation, because being with Jesus is our one goal. This life, this imperfect life, will pass, but our life with Jesus is forever. And so, let us watch with joyful anticipation for the coming of the Lord. Maghintay tayo ng may kagalakan sa muling pagdating ni Jesus. Number 2, pray. In Luke 21, verse 36, Jesus said, "Be vigilant at all times and pray that you have the strength to escape the tribulations that are imminent and to stand before the Son of Man." Kaya't maging handa kayo sa lahat ng oras. Lagi ninyong idalangin na magkaroon kayo ng lakas upang makaligtas sa lahat ng mangyayaring ito at makaharap sa anak ng tao. Be vigilant and pray. Maghihanda at manalangin. To be vigilant means to keep careful watch, to be alert and awake, to be attentive and observant, maging gising at mapagmasid. The Lord instructs us to be open-eyed, to be watchful, and to pray. Prayer is an essential component in our being watchful for the coming of the Lord. We have to be devoted to a daily prayer time. Spend time with the Lord in a quiet place. Read His Word daily. Hear Mass with devotion. And even if we still don't receive communion physically, receive Him spiritually in your heart. The more we pray, the closer we will be to God. So let us continue to be vigilant and to pray. Maging handa at manalangin. Number 3, purify ourselves. In 1 John chapter 3, verses 2 and 3, we read, "Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like Him, for we shall see Him as He is." Everyone who has this hope based on Him makes himself pure as He is pure. Alam natin sa pagparitong muli ni Kristo, tayo'y matutulad sa Kanya, sapagkat makikita natin siya sa likas na kalagayan. Kaya't ang sino mang may pag-asa sa Kanya ay nagpapakalinis tulad ni Kristo. John tells us that if we have this hope, we have to keep ourselves pure. We have to purify ourselves in spirit, soul, and body. Ang sino mang may pag-asa sa Kanya ay nagpapakalinis tulad ni Kristo. A daily examination of conscience will remind us of the things we have to repent of. We also have to distance ourselves from things that may pollute our minds and bodies. Let us purify ourselves as we prepare for the coming of the Lord. Number 4, abide in Him. In 1 John chapter 2, verse 28, we read, "And now, children, remain in Him, so that when He appears, we may have confidence and not be put to shame by Him at His coming." Kaya nga, mga anak, manatili kayo sa Kanya upang maging panatag ang ating loob sa muling pagparito Niya at hindi tayo mahiya sa Kanya sa araw na iyon. St. John exhorts us to remain in Him, to abide in Jesus. Manatili tayo sa Kanya. To abide means to dwell, or in current language, to hang around. I hear my grandson say, we'll just hang. What does it mean to hang? It means they will just be around friends. They will be with one another. In the same manner, to abide with Jesus means to be with Him. To hang with Jesus, so to speak. To be in His presence constantly, manatili sa presensya ng Panginoon. If we want to prepare for His coming, we have to abide in Him constantly. Number 5, eagerly await. In Hebrews chapter 9, verse 38, we read, so also Christ offered once to take away the sins of many will appear a second time, not to take away sin, but to bring salvation to those who eagerly await Him. Siya muling darating hindi upang ihandog na muli dahil sa kasalanan, kundi upang iligtas ang mga naghihintay sa Kanya. He will bring salvation to those who eagerly await Him. Siya'y darating para sa mga malugod na naghihintay sa Kanya. Eagerly await. Sabik na naghihintay. Masugid na nagmamasid. Sinasabi sa Hebreo na dapat tayong maghintay sa pagdating ng Panginoon ng may kagalakan. Hallelujah. Nakakita na ba kayo ng pamilya ng OFW na naghihintay sa airport? Makikita mo ang excitement at pag-aasam sa kanilang mga mukha. At pagdating na ng kanilang ina, ama o asawa, naku, talaga namang humihiyaw sa tuwa at naghahalo na ang luha at tawa sa galak na nararamdaman nila. Ganyan tayo dapat sa ating paghihintay sa Panginoon. Full of love and excitement. Puno ng pagmamahal, kagalakan at pag-asa. And so, to summarize, here are the 5 things we should do to prepare for the coming of the Lord. Watch. Pray. Purify ourselves. Abide in Him. Eagerly await. I hope that as we do these things, we shall one day witness the coming of the Lord. Together, in Jesus' name, Amen.
Maraming salamat, Brother Willy, for that inspiring message. Elim Community's vision is to spread the good news to the ends of the earth. If you want to be part of this work of evangelization, please give your tithes, love offerings, and donations to Springs Foundation Incorporated, BPI Kamuning Branch, account number 3141-0667-56, BDO Kamuning Branch, account number 115-801-5470. Email deposit slip to mavicargamosa@gmail.com.
We pray for all those who gave their tithes and love offerings. May the Lord bless you 100-fold for your generosity. In Jesus' name, Amen.
Prayer to Our Lady of Elim. O dear Mary, Lady of Elim, sweet and pure, pray that your Son Jesus will, to innocence and holiness restore, the hearts and minds of long-lost souls. Pray that the seed of glad tidings sown in our hearts will stir us to great hope, faith, and love. Pray for the vision and intentions of community and of the Church, that with the Lord's watchful care and generous provisions, they shall all be. Pray that the polluted world and all institutions will, from a powerful outpouring of the latter rain, experience the blessings of fresh living water, a renewal of the spirit and healing of our land and of all nations. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Elim Missions Prayer. Lord, I make myself available for the ministry of missionary evangelization. On my knees or in the mission field, within our borders or on foreign soil, for a single soul or for the multitudes. Empower me for abundant soul winning. By your Spirit, make me an instrument of your love and mercy, a witness bold and unashamed, and an inspiring bearer of the good news. Send us the laborers, technology, and resources to reach the world. Help us break barriers, overcome obstacles, and penetrate new territories, that all the peoples of the earth may know that you are God and there is no other. And to all those who reach, Lord, raise them up to become your true disciples. Here I am, Lord. Send me. In Jesus' name, amen.
Oratio Imperata. God, our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted, may they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen.
Our Lady, Health of the Sick,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael, the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Roch,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, this is a subject matter from our hearts. We truly look forward to the coming and the return of Jesus Christ. We know that this is your will also, that we await with eager anticipation and longing the coming of the Lord. As we see the day come, day by day, we know that the fulfillment of your promises will come to pass, and we will ourselves experience that reunion in the heavenlies with Jesus, our Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for joining us.
Thank you. And see you again next week.
See you.
God bless. Stay safe. Bye.
love.